Hello, everyone at Grand Ledge Public Library. My name is Laurie Nelson Spielman, and I'm an author, and I'm also a native of Grand Ledge. So I spent many, many wonderful hours at the Grand Ledge Public Library growing up. It's near and dear to my heart. So I'm the author of three books, The Life List, which published in 2013, and Sweet Forgiveness, 2015. And my newest novel that I'll talk to you a little bit about today is The Star-Crossed Sisters of Tuscany. The Star-Crossed Sisters of Tuscany is about a 200-year-old curse on the Fontana family, declaring that second-born daughters will never find lasting love. That is, until Aunt Poppy comes into the picture. Aunt Poppy invites her two great nieces, Amelia and Lucy, to join her for a trip to Italy. They're all second-born daughters, all single, but Poppy vows she's going to meet the love of her life on her 80th birthday on the steps of the Ravello Cathedral. So that's a little bit about what the story is about. It was inspired by a letter that I received back in 2016, after The Life List was published in Germany. I received this six-page, single-spaced letter from a man called Dieter Kretschmar. And Dieter had grown up in East Germany during World War II. He was now an elderly widower, and had a fascinating story about growing up in East Germany and how he escaped later from communist East Germany. And left behind his love and then later went back for her. But he wanted me to write his life story. And I wrote back saying that it was fascinating, but I don't write biographies. Anyway, he and I have become wonderful pen pals. We write every day, we email each other, and we even met in person a few years ago when he came to the US. But his story stuck with me, and I thought, what would happen? You know, what does happen if one person is trapped behind the Iron Curtain back in the day and the other escaped? And so that was the inspiration for my side story about Rico and Poppy. And Rico is who Poppy is planning to meet on the steps of the Ravello Cathedral. So that was the inspiration for that. And the curse is basically a reason. I needed a reason, a compelling reason, why someone would believe they would never find love. The idea of never, of knowing from an early age, of being told from an early age, you're never going to marry, was intriguing to me. I wondered how that would affect a person, and I imagined it would affect them in one of two ways. Either it would free you and you would live very authentically and without any pressure of finding Mr. Right, or in Lucy's case, being desperate to break the curse. So I've got three women on this trip to Italy. One, they're all second-born cursed, supposedly cursed never to find love. One of them is Aunt Poppy, who thinks she's going to find love still at age 80. One is Amelia, a happily single baker who doesn't give a hoot about what she looks like or who she impresses, has no illusion of ever finding love. And we also have Luciana, Lucy, who is, like I said, just desperate to break the curse. So that is my story. It takes you from Brooklyn, the Italian-American Fontana family, and then sweeps you away to Venice, Tuscany, and eventually the Amalfi Coast of Italy. So thank you so much. Again, the book is The Star-Crossed Sisters of Tuscany. Thank you so much, and Happy New Year.